Remember the 80s? Strange times. People didn't go to the gym back then. They did jumping jacks in front of the TV and leg warmers and headbands. The craze swapped his gold lame leotard for a crack pipe in the 90s, but is reportedly now clean and in the best shape of his life. That's Vinewood's code for he's trying to make a comeback.
Gentlemen, is the famous Richard
shoehorned into the final edits right behind those very gates. Everyone has a favorite Solomon Richards movie. An American Divorce really helped me through a difficult time when I was bankrupting my first husband. Oh, come on, don't people in the Midwest watch movies? You must have seen Defender of the Faith. No? Wow, tough crowd.
About a bad investment. Hey! We best lay low, bitch!
Just up ahead on the right is where Delancey Madua's septum fell out after a ketamine party.
I wonder, is a bathroom close by?
I'm so crunk, I can pee my pants.
Remember, these people are rich and beautiful.
I was gonna get lunch at Limey's.
That makes them better than us. Okay, people, get those cameras out. This is Portola Drive. You won't get a better chance to spot a celebrity in its natural habitat. As you can see, recession hasn't hit this part of town very hard. These are some of the most offensively high-end designer stores in the country. And now, some fun trivia for you. There have been a number of movies shot on Portola Drive, mostly awful ones about rich idiots, including the blockbuster 2005 romantic comedy, Shoehorn. It's credited with sending women's rights back 50 years. The store we're passing now is where British star Charlotte Crown was caught on film in the changing room, eating and purging the same burrito over and over again, just like a dog.
I take a picture of this.
This is the Epsilon Center. Anyone with red hair, please cover it for your own safety. If you really want to meet a famous celebrity, this place is packed full of them. Take an introductory course. It changed my life. Kifla! You'll recognize road from those videos of Jill von Krastenberg with the Romanian shot put team.
Oh, child, this is just so exciting.
I wonder what the real estate market is in.
Don't you just love people you've never met and would have you arrested if you came within 10 feet of them?
Do you see all the plastic women?
And here is City Hall. This is where the mayor's office is, if any of you care. You might recognize this building from the 20-minute final dogfight to save Earth in the movie Invasion Los Santos.
To bleep this to my friends.
Please refrain from taking photos of ethnic minorities. They could be gang members.
You take not cutting here.
You wouldn't believe what that one sold for.
I always read about this in the books.
The next corner is where actor Scott Stevens famously prolapsed after a failed party trick.
I don't do homeboy.
I'm so into this paleo diet.
Lord, I feel like I'm in a movie.
I've seen this before on the television.
For Asians in the 1920s, the name could have been a lot worse. There's a saying that to go to Los Santos and not see the Oriental Theater is like going to China and not visiting a burger shop. I've never really understood what that means, but...
I'm a winner, you see? I am!
And here we are, back on the strip. As they say in Vinewood, that's a wrap, folks. I hope I managed to take your minds off the economic downturn for just a little while. I'd like to remind any Europeans that 1%...
I'm still mad.